Welcome to Rickard Learning. Today we're going to get the app Screencastify and then I'm going to show you how to use it. So first of all, you're going to go to your apps on your dashboard. You'll go to your apps and you will find the Chrome Web Store. It's also down here. So here's the Chrome Web Store. And you're going to search for it. So it's a screencasting, free screencasting app. So Screencastify. And then you just enter for the search. So it is an extension, which means it's going to show up over here. So we're going to click Add to Chrome. And we say, yep. Add it, and then you'll notice over here a little thing that looks like this little film strip thingy will pop up. It's kind of doing its thing, checking, and there it goes. It has been added to Chrome. So I'm going to click that off. I don't want that. So let me show you now how to use it. So first of all, we're going to go and click right here. It's going to open up a little window. So it says congratulations, and then I'm going to choose Google Drive to store things, and then I'm going to grant that permission. And then I'm going to say get started, and this little video is going to pop up, and you should watch it because it's, you know, it's decent, but I'm not going to watch it. So yeah, so then let's say I'm doing something, I am doing a tutorial of Tinkercad or something, and I want to create a video of what I am doing. So I will be talking and showing my work. So when you want to do that, you're going to come over here, you're going to click it. Let me just get rid of this thing, make a new tab. Come on. Slow. Okay, so I want to do a new screencast. So I'm going to come over here to the thing that looks like a little film, piece of film, and I'm going to click on it. And here it is. So you have tab, you have desktop, and you have cam. So use cam if you want to take a video of yourself. We don't want to do that. We want desktop, not tab, because if you do tab, it's just going to show this, what's on the tab, and there's nothing going on the tab. So if I want desktop, then it's going to show everything that I do, like my cursor, and if I am, you know, moving around, I don't know. So it's going to do all that. Then you want to look at your microphone. It's got the built-in one, default. Notice this here, this is your levels. If you get really close and you talk really loud, then it's going to go up into the red. So you don't want to, you want to, you know, kind of make sure that you're not going into the red, because that'll overmodulate and it'll sound really bad. Let's see, is that everything? Yeah. So then we're going to click Start Recording. And it's going to come up and say, do you want the tab or the entire screen? So it's again. So you want the entire screen, and you're going to say share. So now it's going. So whatever I do, if I'm like cruising around, doing stuff, typing stuff in, like Tinkercad. Oh, I just wrote Tinkercard. Oops. Whatever. It'll figure it out. It's going really slow because I'm screencasting, so let's say I want to videotape myself doing a tutorial in Tinkercad. It's going to follow what I'm doing, and it's going to record my voice. So because a tutorial, you are talking about what you're doing, just like I am now. So once you're finished and you have created you've done everything you need to do, you're going to come back over to this. It's got a red dot on it, meaning it's recording. I'm going to click on it and wait for it. And then I'm going to click, see up here is how long it goes. And it will only go for 10 minutes on this free version, and then it will automatically stop. So if you have something going on longer than 10 minutes, you'll have to do part two. So you click stop. And then a window is going to pop up. And it'll start going as the video.
So now it's going. So whatever I do.
So I'm going to stop that. So the first thing you want to do is give it a title, because you don't want it to be called Untitled Screencast, because that's kind of boring. So whatever you're doing, like Tinkercad, Basics or something like that. I don't know. Whatever your tutorial is that you're going to be doing, because that's, you're going to be using Screencastify to do tutorials. So you name it, and then you're going to come up here and you want to share. And this is why we had to make a YouTube account, because now you're going to have to select your YouTube channel. So we're going to click it, and now that we have selected our YouTube channel, we are going to upload. So click upload, even though I really don't want that to upload because it's going to be kind of lame. I'll have to delete it. So then you watch over there, and this was the status bar saying that it was uploading into YouTube. Here is the link. So if you click that, now it says link has been copied. So if you want to see what your video looks like, you go up here, new tab, and then you can control or command C, whatever it is, copy paste. You probably want to paste. So you do a paste into the address bar, and then it will bring up YouTube where the video is. It's probably loading, so it'll probably say, sorry, went back. Oh, mine was so short that it...
So now it's going. So whatever
it videotaped, I mean, it loaded it up pretty quick, but if you do a 10-minute one, it's going to take a while. So there it is. So when you have that done, then what you're going to do is you're going to take this link, and you're going to copy it, and then you're going to paste it into the form. Let's see if I can find that really quick. What did I do with that? I think I put it away. So you'll just go to my website, and it'll say turn in the link to your YouTube video tutorial thingy, and you'll turn in this, because this will take me to your video. All right, so there you go. I think that's it. Yeah, so that's it. That's your tutorial for Screencastify. Oh, last thing is, if you want, you can click on it. Hello, any day now. And then, it should show you, I used to, show you all of the ones that you have made. Maybe it's up here now? Yeah, your recordings. So these are like all the recordings I've been doing lately. So unless you delete them, which is that little trash can. So like here, I can delete that one because I don't need that one anymore. It's an old one. So these are some of the videos I just made. And you can see all of your videos that are stored in Screencastified. But you are going to want to put them all into your YouTube channel. So everything that you put up from Screencastify will be in your video section. So you'll see them all in here. Okay? All right. There you go. Hope.